Hey, it's Scott once again, and today I want to talk about the concept of mastery and becoming a master coach. Now, I am not speaking here of a specific certification or qualification that maybe, you know, in your different sports, maybe there's a master level. I know in officials there's masters and things like that. But I'm talking about the word mastery and the word becoming, you know, the concept of becoming a master coach. And this came to me, well, this one's been in my mind for quite some time, but it also came to me just recently after hearing a quote. I heard a quote from, I heard a guy named Pat Flynn, who I listen to on his podcasts, quoting another podcaster, John Lee Dumas, who said, "Every master started as a disaster." Now, I love the quote because it gets you thinking, okay, those of us seeking a level of mastery, those of us seeking to get to, you know, whatever would be considered a master in your realm, need to recognize you're not going to start there. You know, now I don't necessarily agree that you have to start as a disaster, but I think for a fact, you know, the quote really makes a good point. You're not going to start at your best. And all of us have to start somewhere. And where we start is usually at the bottom. And we start climbing and working our way up. And so the idea that, you know, every master started as a disaster is something for us to consider when we're thinking about, well, where are we now on our journey and where do we want to get to? About a year ago, I think, in one of these videos, I talked about the concept, don't compare your beginning with someone else's middle or someone else's end. You're on two totally different roads. Use what they can offer you, you know, and the experience and guidance that they can offer you. Use that to the best of your ability to become better and to climb and to get on that road where you want to go. But don't compare where you are as you're starting out with where other people are as they're later, much later in their careers. And the concept of this becoming a master coach, where I first started thinking a lot about it and trying to do some things, actually some printed materials with it, was when I'd sit in principals' offices. You know, past principals who I worked for, also my wife. She's been a middle school principal and now a grade school principal. And they would have in their on their cabinets, shelves sometimes, and I'd be sitting waiting or whatever it might be, and they would get a thing called the master teacher. In fact, one of our principals got that for all of us as teachers, and we'd get that, I think, like once a month or once every couple of weeks, put in our mailboxes. It was a little pamphlet that just talked about certain concepts to help you become the best teacher you can be, and I always really liked them. And I saved mine. In fact, I probably have them somewhere in a box around here because I really liked them. And then I took a lot of the concepts from there and transferred them to my coaching because teaching is coaching. And so the concepts worked out really well the same, I thought. But anyway, the concept of becoming a master coach, understand it's a road that you're on. It's going to take time. Do you ever fully get there? I don't know. You know, hopefully you're more masterful as you move on throughout your career than you were when you started. But I don't know what it takes to get to the level to become, you know, what some would call a master coach. A lot of it is experience. A lot of it is the years that you put in. But it's not just years. What are you doing with those years? Do you study? Do you go to clinics? Do you read? Do you watch videos? Do you talk to other coaches? Are you upgrading your knowledge? And then, excuse me, are you applying the things that you're learning? Are you working to be your best at those things? Have you worked on all types of coaching elements, not just your sport-specific coaching elements? Whatever the case may be, to seek to be a master coach is the most important thing. To do all that you can to become your best is really what this should be all about. Because the master coaches in our world, in my opinion, are the coaches who we like to call coaches of significance. Coaches who are making an impact in kids' lives. And they are significant portions in kids' lives, so much so that kids then take the things they learn from those coaches, go out into the real world, and apply them in their lives. consider this concept as you can continue to you know, work your way through your coaching career. And hopefully you feel at some point that you have achieved that level of master coach. However, once you have achieved it, are you done? Well, I hope not, because the best masters are always seeking to learn more, always seeking to climb, always seeking to get better, always, and quite honestly, rarely consider themselves master coaches. Always think there's more for me to do, and there's more that I can do to get better. They say John Wooden, even in his last years of his coaching, was still working on making his practice plans better, doing all that he could to be the best he could be. That's what we really should be doing. In many ways, that's the true master coach, one who, though he or she has reached a certain level of proficiency, never believes that they're at the level they need to be at, always seeking to get better. So anyway, something for you to think about, becoming the best you can be, becoming a master coach. We'll talk to you again next week.